In this video, we're going to do two of the problems from Writing Linear and Exponential Models Practice, which is in your lab book on pages 39 and 40. So I'm going to do two of the problems for you to get you started, and then you'll do the rest of them on your own for practice. So we're going to start off with number one. Well, my computer just did something weird. All right, we're back. So we're going to start off with number one on page 39. And it says, the price of a computer is $1,500 today, and its value decreases at a rate of $250 per year. What will the value of the computer be after 6 months? All right, so the first thing we need to ask is decide, is this linear, or is, actually, no, that's the second thing. The first thing is, what is the independent variable, and what is the dependent variable? So if you remember correctly, the independent variable goes into the function, and the dependent comes out. And the independent is what determines the dependent. So we've got two values at play. We have the cost of a computer, and we have time. So we've got to decide, does the cost of the computer determine how much time has passed, or does the amount of time determine what the computer is worth? And it's going to be the amount of time that has passed determines how much the computer is worth. I would say if time is one of the variables, it's almost always the independent. Not always, but I would say probably 98% of the time, if time is involved, it's the independent. So we want our time, and we can do it in years or we can do it in months, but let's do it in years since we're told that it's decreasing at a rate of 250 per year. So our dependent variable is the value, and that is in dollars. So now we have to decide, is this linear or is this exponential? So you have to ask yourself, is it going up or down by a set amount or by a set percentage? And in this case, since it tells us it's changing at a rate of $250 per year, that's a set amount, so this is going to be a linear relationship. So we need to come up with a function in the form of y equals mx plus b. We need to find what is its slope and how much did it start out at. So it tells us that the computer was $150 today. So that's how much it's starting at. That's our initial value. So that's going to be our B. And it's decreasing at 250 per year. It's going down by a set amount. That's our slope. So our model is going to be Y equals, it's going down, so negative 250X plus starting off at $1,500. So that's going to be our model. Again, our slope tells us how much we're going up or down. In this case, we're going down 250 per year. And our B is our initial value. It tells us what we're starting at. That's 1,500. So that's our equation. And then we want to know what is the value of the computer after 6 months. Now, this is tricky. Our independent is in years. This is in months. So you have to ask yourselves, what is 6 months in years? And you can do a quick unit conversion to see that 6 months is 0.5 of a year. So to figure out its worth after 6 months, which is 0.5 of a year, we need to put that value into our equation. So I'm going to do equals, because anytime you want Excel to do math, you have to start off with an equal sign. Negative 250 times 0.5 plus 1,500 to see that 6 months from now, our computer is going to be worth $1,375. Moving on to number two. Again, first thing we need to figure out is what is our independent and what is our dependent variables. So number two says, in 1995, the enrollment at a certain university was 2,400 students. If the enrollment increases by 11% per year, what will the enrollment be in the year 2008? So we're looking at the time and we're looking at the number of students. So we're going to let our independent be time in years, and that will determine the number of students that we have. So now we need to decide, is this linear or is this exponential? So again, look at how it's changing. In this case, it says we're increasing by 11%. A constant percentage, that's going to be an exponential function. It's going to have the form, I'm going to write it as q of t, or quantity times t is q naught, our initial value, times 1, either plus or minus, our rate, written as a decimal, raised to our variable. So in this case, our quantity, let's see, Q naught is our initial value. It tells us that in 1995, that was 2,400 students. And then we're increasing by 11%. That written as a decimal is going to be 0.11. and then raised to the t. So there's our model. Our initial value times 1, either plus or minus your change written as a decimal, raised to the t. And then it says, what will the enrollment year be in the year 2008? Well, we're measuring in years since 1995. So 1995 is considered year zero. So you need to ask yourselves, how old will somebody be if they were born in 1995 in 2008? And maybe, who knows, maybe some of y'all were born in 1995. That makes me feel really old. So let's see, 1995, 10 years later would be 2005, 3 years later is 2008, so that's 13 years later. So we need to put 13 into our equation. So I'm going to type it in as 2400 times. You've got to put that times before the parentheses, otherwise Excel's not going to do it and you'll get very confused. So 2400 times, parenthesis 1 plus 0.11 raised to the, we said it was 13 years later, to see that in 2008 we will have approximately 9,319.87 students. That's pretty good growth.